What's up, guys? Welcome to my channel. I am Just Jen. That's me. Hello. So, Eminem. I started listening to Eminem, the Marshall Mathers LP. Slim Shady, Eminem, Marshall Mathers, whatever you want to call him. Eminem is one fantastical rapper. Grew up in Detroit, Michigan, in a trailer park, nonetheless, with a piece of crap mother. I strive to be a good mother because of stories like Eminem's. Eminem also talked about his addiction, which means he's okay in my eyes. He put it out there, he beat it, and he talked about beating his addiction. I just got done recording Rap God. Amazing. And he did touch on his addiction again in there. So this time I am doing none other than Godzilla. And this is featuring Juice WRLD. If it's your first time here and if you haven't subscribed yet, please hit that subscribe button next to it's the notification bell. Make sure you tap the all button so you're notified when I'm live or drop a new video like this one. Speaking of likes, make sure you smash that like button and leave in the comments because I love talking to all of you. Check that out. I went all like Eminem flow, kind of like spit them lyrics real quick. From what I read, this here, 160 some syllables in a minute, and all of the people trying to do the Godzilla challenge, I laughed. I knew one person that tried to do it, and I was like, shut the fuck up. You can't do it. Knock it off. All right, you guys. Eminem featuring Juice WRLD. I'm a metal chick, by the way, but I've always loved Eminem. Here we go.
You're a monster.
I can swallow a bottle of alcohol in a feel like Godzilla. Better hit the deck like a cartilla. My whole squad's in here walking around the party. A cross between a zombie apocalypse and Bobby.
He's drunk as the fuck. Like, I like his little Godzilla guys behind him. I remember watching those in like the 80s. Like, the best was Godzilla versus like the baby Godzilla. What is it? Godzuki and Mothra. Like Mothra. So cool. But he's shit face annihilated.
Brain meaning, which is probably the same reason I wrestle with mania shades in this bitch. I'm posse up. Consider it to cost me a costly mistake if they sleeping on me. The hoes better get insomnia. Hey.
He's a man and a woman. Look at him.
DHD hydroxy cut. In AA with an AK melee, finna set it like a play date, better vacate, retreat like a vacay mayday. This beat is cray cray, Ray J, H A, H A, H A. Laughing all the way to the bank, I spray flames, they cannot tame a placate.
So I just have a question. What the hell did MGK, what was he thinking? Like, I'm from Cleveland, Ohio, and even I was scratching my head, like, are you sure you want to do this, bro? Like, do you want to kill your career? Just wondering. Nick Cannon as well? Like, were you all drunk as the fuck? Like, high as fuck? Off your mental meds? What is the major malfunction going on here? Like, this is Eminem. I just don't understand it. Like, why? Dum-dums. I mean, I just gotta rewind this. Look at this. Eyeballs.
Is cray cray Ray J, H A, H A, H A. Laughing all the way to the bank, I spray flames that cannot tame or placate the
monster. You get in my way, I'ma feed you to the monster. I'm normal during the day, but at night turn to a monster. When the moon shines like ice road truckers, I look like a villain out of those blockbusters.
Fire,
fire, monster. Blood on the dance floor, the Louis V carpet.
Fire, fire, to the fire.
I don't think those are the balls he was talking about, honey bunny. Boy, she's licking that basketball. Do you know that smell of new basketball? It's like the most rubbery smell. Like you walked into a damn Michelin tire factory and you are licking some balls. It stinks. Like the shit stinks. Like if you ever walked into like the basketball section of Dick's Sporting Goods, you're like, ew, God, so much rubber. Disgusting. Here she is licking them. No shame whatsoever. Wrong bows, baby. Wrong bows. But hey, to each their own, eh?
Adam just appalled at so many things that pissed them off. It's impossible to list them all. And in the midst of all this, I'm in a mental hospital with a crystal ball. Trying to see what I'll still be like this tomorrow. Whisper doll versus whisper. My fist is ball back up against the wall. Pencil drawn.
This is just a song to go ballistic on. You just pulled a pistol on the guy with a missile launcher. I'm just a Loch Ness.
That's what happened. Eminem, okay, I get it now. MGK came at Eminem with a pistol, like a 22 caliber, maybe even a 20 caliber. It was like, pew, 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 pew. And he was like, oh, fuck, hold up. Boom, missile launcher on his shoulder, like, all right, then, let's do this. Poof. That's what happened in Machine Gun Kelly. You need to rename yourself to 20 caliber or 22. That's the smallest, right? 22? Yeah. Rename yourself, buddy. You're not a machine gun no more. You're a 22.
Mythological, quick to tell a bitch you off like a fifth of vodka. When you twist the top of the bottle, I'm a
monster. You get in my way, I'ma feed you to the monster. I'm normal during the day, but at night turn to a monster. When the moon shines like ice road truckers, I look like a villain at a...
Did he just throw up some Legos? Now step on one of those motherfuckers with your bare feet and tell me you don't know what... You're gonna know what pain is. You step on a Lego barefoot. My God, you'd be crying to every God that existed. Buddha, Jesus, everybody. Like, oh my God, Jesus, Buddha, holy hellfire. What has just happened to me? My God, that's my worst fear. I have a 3-year-old. I don't buy him Legos for that very reason.
Those blockbusters.
Until the fire spit a monster.
Blood on the dance floor. Louis V carpet.
Fire. Until the fire.
I'm on point like my index is. So all you will ever get is some motherfucking finger. Finger, prostate exam. Damn. How can I have all these fans that perspire like a liar's pants? I'm on fire and I got no plans to retire and I'm still the...
I like that. He ain't got no plans to retire. Well, that's good. You got all those rappers coming after you, Eminem, and they think that they're going to retire you like MGK and like Nick Cannon. It's like, what the fuck is... Yeah, you guys. Like, dude grew up in a trailer park in Detroit. He was like the only white kid for like 20 miles. Like, he's tough. He's tough. The only people that should be in a mental institution are the people that think that they could take Eminem down. Like, for a while there, I stopped listening to him, and I'm just like, well, oh, what the problem is, Jennifer? What the problem is? Because I'm stupid. That's the only logical explanation. I think I said that already.
The man you admire, these chicks are spazzing out. I only get more handsome and flyer. I got them passing out like what you do when you hand someone flyers. And what goes around comes around just like the blades on the chainsaw. Cause I caught the flag, but my dollar stacked right off the bat like a baseball. Like kidding, bitch, I got them racks with so much ease that they call me Diddy. Cause I make bands and I call getting cheese a cakewalk. Yeah. Bitch, I'm a player. I'm too motherfucking stingy for share. Won't even lend you an ear. Ain't even pretending to care. But I tell a bitch I'm Mary of Shabaria. Face of my genital area. The
word, man. I feel you. I feel you. Gotta give good head, man. Gotta give good head.
General Richard Ramirez, Christian Rivera. Cause my lyrics never sit well. So they wanna give me the chair. Like a paraplegic and it's scary. Call it Harry Carey. Cause every time I'm digging Harry Carey, I'm Mary, a motherfucking dictionary. I'm swearing up and down. They can spit this shit's hilarious. It's time to put these bitches in the obituary column. We wouldn't see eye to eye with a staring problem. Get the shaft like a staring column.
So that's what I like. You know, my one of my favorite songs by Eminem is Stan. Stan. It told a story and you're just like, at the end, you're like, you're like emotionally invested, right? And by the end, you're just like, my God, this is Dan. This is you. Damn. I thought the same thing. Like, damn. My God. He ties in his music so beautifully. You know, he tells a story and you might think it sounds like gibberish, but it really does all tie in, doesn't it? Yeah. Sure does. It ties in beautifully. And that is why I really do feel bad for being like, dude, I'm just going to say it right here, right now. I love other rappers. They're great. But Eminem, I think that he does deserve the GOAT, the GOAT, the greatest of all time rapper award. Because listen to this, man. It's not just who he is because he speaks what is on his mind. And he's a good influence because he got through his addiction, right? And he came from nothing, and look where he is today. But just the genius behind the lyrics. He writes these lyrics. Sorry, not sorry.
Drinking happy packy, but it's black ink. Evil half of the bad meats. Evil that means take a backseat. Take it back to fat beats with a maxi single. Look at my rap sheet. What attracts these people is my gangster bitch like Apache with a catchy jiggle. I stack chips. You better got a half eaten Cheeto.
Oh!
Oh, what the fuck? Mike?
M.
Did he just get knocked the fuck out by Mike Tyson? Oh my God, Mike Tyson just got him. Yeah. Listen, if Mike Tyson punched you in the face, you're gonna be on the ground too, because that dude hits hard. Like, real hard. I wouldn't want to get punched in the face by Mike Tyson. Hell no. That'd be getting punched in the face by a steam locomotive, like by a train. Kapow! Quicker than shit.
Is that you?
Oh, oops.
I mean, please, man, I'm sorry. Please forgive me. Fuck.
Dealing with the venom and eliminate him. Other words, I'm intimate him. I don't want to hurt him, but I did him in a fit of rage. I'm murdering again. Nobody will evade him. Finna kill him and dump with the fucking bodies in the lake. Obliterating everything is generated. Renegade him. Hit him. Make anybody who want it with the pen and frame. Don't nobody want it, but they're gonna get it anyway. I'm beginning to feel like I'm mentally ill. I'm a tele killer. Be killed. I'm a killer. Be the vanilla gorilla. You're bringing a killer within me out of me. You don't want to be the enemy of the demon who in me. I'll be a receiving enemy. What stupidity it'd be. Every bit of me's the epitome of a spitter when I'm in the vicinity. Motherfucker, you better duck or you finna be dead the minute you run into me. 100% of you is a fifth of a percent of me. I'm about to fucking finish you, bitch. I'm available. You wanna battle? I'm available. I'm blowing up like an inflatable. I'm undebatable. I'm unavoidable. I'm unevadable. I'm on the toilet bowl. I got a trailer full of money and I'm paid for. I'm not afraid to pull the
man stop.
What the crap is going on here? He's got Dr. Dre. First of all, Eminem is in the bed. Or is that Marshall Mathers? Where's Slim Shady? Wait a minute. Slim Shady's blonde, so he's no longer Slim Shady. But we've got Eminem as a doctor or a physician's assistant. The physician is Dr. Dre. Mike Tyson's over here like, I'm sorry, man. I'm so sorry. Fuck. Here's Band-Aid. His mouth falls off, and they're chasing her. Dr. Dre's looking at it like, what in the hell is this? You just spit like 160,000 syllables just there in 1 minute. I think that was like the record, right? 160 syllables. He might have broke the Guinness World Record with that. And then there is, there's him in the bed, like just beat all the fuck up because Mike Tyson just whooped his ass with one punch, like one hit or quit or shit. Yeah, that's Mike Tyson for you. Still love the dude, man. He's so awesome.
Look what I'm planning.
Well, he killed him.
I hope everybody having a good day.
Oh yeah.
Hope everybody accomplished something significant. Even if you didn't accomplish anything significant, don't be discouraged. Just aim to accomplish something significant tomorrow.
That's right.
And the next day. So,
that's right. Listen to him.
If anybody's going through anything, I hope and I pray that you get through it. And just know that you do have the strength to get through whatever the fuck you're going through, no matter what it is.
Now, I think that was nice that they paid homage and memorialized Juice WRLD like that. If I'm not mistaken, he was on an airplane, and I think that he took a bunch of medication. I'm not sure. Don't quote me on that, because I'm more into metal than anything. So I don't know if that was true. I remember hearing a rapper going on a private jet. Somebody probably snitched him out. Don't be a snitch. Just don't do that. That ain't cool. But I heard that some rapper, I don't know, correct me if I'm wrong, because God forbid I'm wrong, I'm a human being. But I heard that a rapper took a bunch of opiates, like Percocets and stuff, on a private jet. He got snitched out, and instead of just saying, hey, here's these pills, they're mine, he took them all and died. I don't know if that happened or not. But I liked his message at the end. Like, strive for greatness, basically, is what he said. And don't be discouraged, and don't take it so personally if you don't reach these goals. Sometimes we can't reach goals. Sometimes we set our goals a little too high and a little bit unrealistic and have these unrealistic expectations that we can get Lamborghinis or all of that. We need to be good role models for our youth and teach them good morals. and teach them that if they work hard for something, they're going to achieve something better than if they go sell drugs, you know. But because when you're selling drugs, kids, believe it or not, the only place you're going to end up is either dead or in jail or prison. It's not worth it. Believe me when I say it's not worth it. It's not spending time in prison. I was there for 3 fucking years and it sucked. All right, you guys, that does it for me. I am just Jen. I think I already gave out all my good life lessons. Eminem, man, keep it up. Keep up the good work. Don't retire. You know, yeah, make sure you hit that subscribe button if you haven't subscribed already. Make sure you smash that like button for me. And leave your suggestions down in the comments. And if you've been through recovery, I want to say congratulations. Keep that shit up and fight that good fight. And look at me, almost 7 years sober. November 1st, 2014 is when I said enough is enough. All right, you guys, take care of yourselves. Stay kind, stay humble, stay true to yourself, and set some goals, man. You never know. You never know what kind of good things are in store for you. All right, guys, make good choices too. Don't be selling drugs and shit. All right, bye.